Konnichiwa YouTubers, this is Restock straight from Point Mugu, California. Today we're going to do a video review of Transformers Animated Blitzwing. This actually came out in 2008. It's a triple changer, just like its G1 counterpart. And just let me show you, this is the quasi-jet mode, which rolls really well, but doesn't have any nose wheel landing gear, which I absolutely hate when they leave that out. Yeah, it's an aviation guy in me. But the colors are fine. A little darker than the G1 counterpart. I believe it was more cream colored. This is a weird gray color, but it looks fine. I like the purple, the red, good molding. Decent, no intakes, which is, you know, this is the most lackluster aspect of the triple changer. There's no doubt. I don't know what those are, but it's in there. We got this over here, which is his head, which is looking good. I mean, it's concealed fairly well. I wish that the cockpit opened up because I love the Decepticon symbol. It looks really good. Nose cone is fine. I like how the tank barrels look like plumes. I know that Hot Rod did that back in the Generations line. It pegs really well, but you can tell that it's a triple changer. It's a plane with tank treads. That's the only thing I don't like. I like how the feet connect in the back and actually support the tank, so it's not a floppy mess in the back, but this doesn't connect too well. Definitely the weaker of the three modes. This gap is there. The tail and vertical stabilizers don't really set really well, but I do like that it tabs on the back, so that's a plus. A little gap issues here and there. Tank treads, it rolls really well for an aircraft. It looks like an F-14 because of the wings just fold out like that. So it's not bad. It could use a little bit more work. Definitely the weaker of the three modes, but it looks good. Huge gap over here, which you know is going to be a tank, so definitely the weakest of the three modes. So 5 out of 10 for this mode. Transformation into a tank isn't too difficult, and yeah, these things actually fire, and I'll show you that with tank mode. So basically what we're going to do right here is just push this out, and we're going to push that back in. Good. And that folds down and his face remains like that. Okay, so we got that. Good. And we're going to basically untab from the feet right here, and the feet are actually going to go back in, which we're going to pull out for the robot mode, which is, there we go. Okay, then we're going to fold the wings down, which I really like the color of these wings. Or the purple just matches really well. And we're just going to fold this up until this tabs into there. And these little slots over here, let's move them up. And voila. Good. Looking good. And the wing pieces just fold together and just neatly tab. Well, they don't tab in anywhere, but they look good. I'm going to rotate that. There we go. Oh, yeah. Sorry. There we go. Awesome. There's your tank. And again, it rolls fairly well. Tank tread's still on there. So, it looks good. It is what it is. Better of the modes, and it fires. I think I had the little things upside down now. Okay, here we go. But they fire. I'll try this one. Am I doing something wrong? Oh, there we go. Okay, there you go. Fires. I like the color. I like the safety orange. I like the purple. I like the gap over here. It's very menacing. Kinda looks like a tank. Still better looking than this plane mode. Tank treads look good. I like the purple again. The molding is good. It's not bad. Even the back, it hides the head really well. So it's not bad looking. Turret rotates 360. Doesn't move up and down, but these little things move independently of each other if you need to. So it is what it is. 6 out of 10 for this mode. And you know that, basically, you know that the engineering went to the robot. So let's get to robot mode. And this transformation isn't too difficult. So we're going to move the legs up. They just accordion out. Put the feet out. And I love the fact that it has that heel spur, so it's really good. Same on that side. Pop that out. Back in. heel spur, because the heel spur neatly is right there. So bam, I like that. Got nice big feet, and you can tell, I like how it hides the arms too. Basically what we're going to do is detach this from the top over here, and hopefully I don't make too much of a mess here. These little two pegs, there we go, these pegs right here, peg over here, and we're going to do that later on, and just fold the arms out. Good. And fold that. I'm going to rotate the cannons up, put the head back up, rotate it 180. Good. His arms are double hinged, which is good just for the transformation. So that's good stuff right here. And let's see, I know that these pegs somewhere. Yeah, there's two pegs. Should attach to something. I'm gonna hide the wings. There we go. Thought they pegged into something. But it does pretty well for what it is. Okay, good. I think I got the transformation fairly well. Oh yeah, put the head down. And this is the gimmick that I like the best, is his three different heads. I like the goggle heads. And this is definitely the mode it was, the this thing, Blitzwing was supposed to be made in this one. I like the three different heads. And there's a little swivel or whatever switch over here in the back that all you have to do is just rotate the heads. I don't know what the heads, they're different personalities and animated line. I like this red head, red face. Good molding on the heads. The jack-o'-lantern head. And of course, whatever this head is. Yo. I like the big, huge eye, small eye, the gimmick, the big, long face. And articulation is pretty good. I wish it had weapons. It kind of hinted on something, because this is purple switch here that doesn't do anything. But articulation is great. The shoulder does shrug. 360 on the shoulder as well. Bicep swivel, double jointed elbow. And a little swivel on the wrist. I wish it actually would swivel 360, but just swivels up in a hinge right there. No waist articulation, but it has a ball joint at the hip, thigh swivel, and a single joint at the knee. And of course, a little bit on the ankle and the heel spur, but it is easy for him to stand because of his big feet. There you go. And I especially like those twin cannons on the back. That just adds a little bit of detail. I wish I had more to it. Definitely Voyager size, bigger than good old Magi Ranger over here. So let me put them with, oh boy, Megatron. So you can see a good size comparison. So not a bad looking figure. And this is the way it was supposed to be. Blitzwing was supposed to be. I know the engineering went to this, and that's why the robot mode just excels. Good 8 out of 10 on that one. All right, YouTubers, that's all I got, and I catch you all next time.